There was a wonderful final chapter today in the spirited and dignified life of Hazel Hawke. Her state memorial was as sophisticated as the woman herself, staged at her beloved opera house with the music that inspired and soothed her soul. Here's Ms. Zoe Ford.
Hand in hand, Bob Hawke and youngest daughter Roslyn arrive at the Sydney Opera House. This was a public memorial, but also a special day for those closest to Hazel Hawke.
The family's grieved and now it's a time to reflect on what was an amazing life that she lived.
And the many other lives she touched.
We've watched her journey over the years.
She was very kind, lovely person.
Hazel Hawke was a Labor Prime Minister's wife, but she transcended politics.
Great lady.
Fought a very difficult illness very bravely.
She was also a big supporter of the arts, so today's concert was as much a thank you as it was a tribute.
But how bemused and delighted she would be to see us gathered together in the Sydney Opera House, her favourite place, together with her favourite band, the Sydney Symphony, playing in her honour.
Music gave Hazel great joy, but so did helping others, especially in raising awareness for Alzheimer's.
And progress is slowly being made. It's not all doom and gloom. And I know she would want us all to keep doing whatever we can.
And with the last word through her grandson David, she may just inspire people to do exactly that.
Don't you dare squander. Bugger that, she would say. Remember one thing as I go on my way. I lived a life filled with laughter and love. I reached all my dreams and I lay happy above.
It was a perfect service. Yeah, everyone's contribution, it was outstanding. Thank you.
Ms. Zoe Ford, 10 News.